Washington's top defense official also in Israel to meet with U.S. troops and oversee the delivery of supplies. Lloyd Austin says the U.S. is ready to deploy more military aid to Israel as it prepares for a likely ground invasion of Gaza. The Pentagon has also ordered roughly 2,000 troops to prepare for a potential deployment to Israel.
You're playing a big part in a really, really important endeavor here. And the Israelis are doing what they need to do to protect their sovereignty and protect their people. They're going to need to do a lot more. They're going to need a lot more stuff. And some of you guys will probably pass through here 3 or 4 times.
U.S. Secretary of State Antony Blinken returns to Israel for further talks. Blinken again assured Israel of Washington's continued support for the country's right to defend itself and its people. Israel's defense minister, meanwhile, thanked the U.S., calling it a great ally.
So let me tell you, Mr. Secretary, this will be a long war. The price will be high, but we are going to win. For Israel, for the Jewish people, and for the values that both countries believe in.
You know our deep commitment to Israel's right, indeed its obligation, to defend itself and to defend its people. And in that, you have and will always have the support of the United States.
The October 7 Hamas attacks killed at least 1,400 people in Israel. Blinken has been in the Middle East since last week, visiting Arab states in a bid to ensure the conflict between Israel and Hamas will not spill over elsewhere in the region. No way in for aid and no way out for civilians. That's the reality faced by Palestinians in Gaza as the war between Israel and Hamas militants rages. In more than a week of Israeli bombardment, over 2,800 Palestinians, including hundreds of children, have been killed. 11,000 more were injured, while 500,000 people were displaced. The diplomatic pressure for a humanitarian corridor is intensifying after Israel declared there will be no ceasefire for the entry of aid and the exit of foreigners.
Canada is calling for unimpeded humanitarian access and a humanitarian corridor. Canada has committed an initial $10 million in humanitarian assistance to provide essentials like food, water, emergency medical aid, and protection assistance to those affected by the crisis in Gaza, the West Bank, and Israel. And I want to be clear. None of this aid is going to Hamas.
The European Union also announcing a humanitarian air bridge operation consisting of several flights to Egypt to bring supplies to Gaza.
In the face of this horror, Israel has the right to defend itself in line with humanitarian and international law. And right now, Palestinians in Gaza are in need of humanitarian help and aid. They cannot pay the price of Hamas barbarism. And this is why the Commission has announced to triple humanitarian aid for civilians in Gaza to €75 million.
Israel has vowed to annihilate the Hamas movement that rules Gaza, putting the enclave of 2.3 million Palestinians under a total blockade. Hopes to rescue dozens of Filipinos stuck in the Israel-Hamas war hinge on the outcome of diplomatic efforts to open an Egyptian border crossing. Some 78 Filipinos are already at the border, while 30 others are in another part of southern Gaza. But they have yet to escape as the Egyptian border remains closed to foreigners.
Hindi papayagan internally ng Hamas yung mga Palestinian nationals na lumabas, nor is there a guarantee that Israel or Egypt, certainly Israel, will allow Palestinians to leave and enter Egypt. So yan ang main issue. Our Filipina spouses will have to make a difficult decision.
Three Filipinos have been killed in the war between Hamas and Israel, while another three remain unaccounted for. Belgium raising its terror threat alert to its top level after a shooting incident killed at least two people. The Swedish victims were shot dead in Brussels, and a man who identified himself as an Islamist militant claimed responsibility in a video posted online. The suspected assailant fled the scene, triggering a massive manhunt. But a prosecutor said there was no evidence that the attacker had any link to the renewed conflict in the Middle East. Reports say the two victims were likely soccer fans, as Belgium hosts Sweden in a Euro 2024 qualifying match. An appeal by the Philippine military to stop China's dangerous and offensive actions in the West Philippine Sea. China once again displayed acts of aggression after its vessel shadowed a Philippine Navy vessel conducting a resupply mission near Pag-asa Island Friday. The AFP slams what it calls Beijing's irresponsible behavior.
They've been doing that already, not just to our Coast Guard, but also to our fishing vessels, and this time with our naval vessels. For us, this action is irresponsible, as it violates specific provisions of the International Convention on Preventing Collision at Sea. This is also irresponsible because it may cause harm to others, especially our people.
As for the National Security Council, it vows to continue asserting the country's maritime rights despite China's harassment.
Coming from the PLA Navy, hindi po matatakot ang ating mga Navy personnel. Mm-hmm. We will continue to do what is necessary to supply our people and of course our fishermen na nangingisda sa karagatan ng West Philippines.
Let's find out what stories our North America Bureau is pursuing right now from our Bureau Chief, TJ Manoto.
Good morning to our friends at The Rundown. We begin with our top story about Filipinos in degrees in regulated professions in British Columbia, Canada. They may soon find it easier to get recognized in their respective fields thanks to a new bill that is set to be filed in BC's legislature. Internationally trained professionals who moved to Canada have struggled for years to get their credentials recognized. But in the wake of reports that new immigrants are projected to fill 38% or 380,000 jobs that will open in British Columbia in the next 10 years, the provincial government is rethinking its process of credential recognition.
Newcomers coming to BC with skills, having studied in other countries, are so important, and we really need qualified workers. And so the BC government is introducing legislation this fall in the legislative session to improve the recognition of foreign credentials for internationally educated professionals.
Elmore said the new legislation that will be introduced will address these barriers and require more accountability and transparency from the regulatory bodies. The new measure, which is expected to pass into law by the end of the year and is expected to have a positive impact on thousands of Filipino professionals in BC, who are still waiting to finally get their licenses to practice in their fields. We go to Virginia Beach, where Virginia Governor Glenn Youngkin celebrated Film History Month with the Filipino community. Virginia Governor Glenn Youngkin joined the PhilAm Community Action Group, or PhilCAG, in Virginia Beach on Wednesday in celebrating the Philippine American History Month by honoring those who have served in the military. The majority of the estimated 45,000 Filipino Americans living in the Hampton Roads region of the state of Virginia have lineage that can be traced to a Filipino relative who served in the U.S. Navy.
No community, I believe, across Virginia and the nation has contributed so mightily than the Filipino community.
But the PhilAm community was not just pleased by the recognition of the governor. They also celebrated the fulfillment of his promise to give military veterans tax exemption on their retirement pay.
That's why it was so important that when we passed through the ability for every one of our veterans to no longer have your retirement taxed up to $40,000 in the Commonwealth of Virginia, that is the money you deserve to.
Yeah! And finally, we head to Los Angeles, where Kapamilya star Kim Chiu, along with soul diva Jaya and comedian Gina Crabb, brought extra joy to PhilAms at the World Remit Symphony Rocks concert. Yeah! It was a rocking good time at the historic Wilshire Ebel Theater in Los Angeles, as Kim Chu, Jaya, and Chyna Crabb entertained the fans at the World Remit Simply Rocks LA concert by TFC and World Remit. Fans came from far and wide to dance and play games with the Chinita Princess and get up close and personal in a special meet and greet.
With World Remit, it's more like intimate event na parang, it's like a family, having a family event. It's parang I'm just performing in front of my family. So parang ganun, more intimate, more fun, and it's a different experience also.
This show was held as an appreciation concert for Filipinos who send money to the Philippines to support their loved ones.
There is some support for your family back home. There is a dream, there is a better future. So we are really grateful that you place your trust in World Remit to deliver this mission.
And those are the top stories making headlines amongst the Filipino community in North America. You can catch more of our stories on our website, news.abs-cbn.com/tfcnews, on the ABS-CBN News YouTube channel, and on the ABS-CBN News app for your smartphones and tablets. I'm TJ Manotok. Back to our friends at The Rundown.